For some months and weeks, I've noticed that I've been having a lot of pain. It's this part of the thumb that's sort of the fleshy part of the thumb. It was really starting to bother me just from holding my phone. I don't text with my phone. I know better than to do that, and I tell everyone I know never to do that. But you know, these tools unfortunately aren't really designed for the human hand. So I got myself one of these little gadgets, and you can hold the phone without using your thumb. But it makes me a little bit wary because it also isn't quite perfect. And I'm always a little bit about shifting an injury from one spot to another because of a shift in ergonomics. So I brought in Dr. Robert Markison. He's a hand surgeon, wonderful, knowledgeable hand surgeon, and our chief medical expert and savior here at RSI Health, to talk about why holding your phone could lead to thumb injuries. So welcome back to the show, Dr. Markison. We're so happy to have you talk about this issue. This idea that, you know, just holding an object could lead to an injury. And I was going in for physical therapy, and then I finally realized it was my phone.
First of all, homage to the human thumb. In 200,000 years of Homo sapienhood, the greatest gift, according to the great paleoanthropologist Mary Marski and Donald Johanson, we developed the opposable thumb, fully opposable. The simian thumb is going in a plane more or less across the hand. Ours is capable of full circumduction at the expense of stability. There are 9 vectors of force crossing the thumb, carpometacarpal, aka basal or trapezio metacarpal joint. This is a vulnerable joint. So you've got a combination of muscles as vectors of force. You've got tendons, muscle tendon units. And this is all delicate. And the position of function of the thumb, let it hang, let it hang, let it hang. That's it, loose as a goose in the thumb web muscle, loose as a goose. And as soon as you go flat-handed, whoa. Now, let me show you what flat-handed looks like. Here's a contour line. Now I'm going to go up into the plane of my fingers. You're going to watch right here. And you can see what happens. This juts out. It jumps out. So you have eccentric, irregular wear of the base of the thumb metacarpal on the trapezium with risk of capsular inflammation. And if you're in an over 50 age group, 20%+ of the time, there'll be radiographic evidence and symptomatic evidence of arthritis of that joint. So we've started deep at the joint level. Very common to have people who are holding in a more or less flat-handed grip and consequently straining this. You've got to realize the basic biomechanics of the thumb. 1 pound here registers 10 to 12x here. It's not unusual to do 3 or 4 pounds, 30, 40 pounds here. So you have force, it's called force coupling, amplification of load right here. So a little grip here goes a long way in threatening this region. So the flat-handed grip on a cell phone makes no sense at all, nor does sustained holding of a cell phone make sense. I don't have my little ring on here. Your choices are a little ring or the pop-up device you have, both of which can be helpful. But the answer is to get a little stand, like a gooseneck stand that clamps on a table or something like that. Always use voice. Don't be doing this, because it may seem simple in the beginning, but then it's the aggregate force going through, summating, aggregating, accumulating at the end of a day, where you can just have a little too much wear and tear, not only on the underlying joint and its ligament complex that cobbles it to other bones and the index metacarpal, but also the overlying thenar muscle, the thenar eminence, okay? So you have all these beautiful little muscles, opponens pollicis, abductor pollicis, brevis, flexor pollicis, adductor, all these wonderful Greek and Latin terms. But these are muscles that really make sure that you can fine tune thumb motion. So since this is about the most broadly represented body part on opposite hemisphere, according to the homunculus drawing, that means you're really disturbing a lot of traffic between brain and thumb and object and back. So never abuse that thumb. If you have a moment of discomfort, back off, be smart, figure out some other way to hold things, because sustained gripping of a cell phone or tablet is not smart.
Yes, I completely agree. And I hope that people will put their phone down and use the speakerphone as much as possible and not hold them. I see people, and it's really kind of frightening. I mean, their knuckles are white. You know, you couldn't take the phone away from them. And a lot of people tend to tense unconsciously. And I think holding an object, you know, same thing happens with a pen. You know, one of my tests about this sort of thing is whether or not I can remove the pen from someone. And, you know, sometimes people are just very invested in holding on. It's the excess tension or nervous energy, I think, goes to the gripping of the object. So anyway, thank you for explaining all of that to us, Dr. Markison.
Be nice to your thumbs. Take them out to lunch.
All right. Well, thank you. And we look forward to seeing you next time. We've got some other really interesting topics that we're going to bring Dr. Markison back to talk about. And we hope to see you then.